Welcome to the Crisk Institute. Today we are going to talk about a retirement problem, and we are going to talk about how to move away from retirement products that may not be so useful at addressing the retirement needs of investors, moving away from retirement products towards meaningful retirement solutions. The fact that we need investment solutions as opposed to products has actually been recognized long ago. So not only does it make perfect intuitive sense, nobody needs off-the-shelf products. We need customized solutions meeting my particular needs. That's obvious, right? It's a tautology. And this recognition has happened a long time ago. So this is a quote from Bob Merton. Robert Merton is a professor at MIT, Nobel Prize winning economist for his work on option pricing theory, but also long-term investment problems like the retirement investment problem. And in 2003, in the Financial Analyst Journal, wrote a paper explaining that, you know, we shouldn't go one size fits all. That's what he says. So it's not new, of course, he said, to say that we shouldn't be one size fits all. Now the problem is, in practice, there's a lot of uniformity. We get a bunch of products and all of us are given the same products, even though they don't meet our needs. Now this is not necessary. Given existing financial thinking and technology, we can do much better than this. We can actually provide meaningful, dedicated investment solutions to these investors. So why don't we do it? And this is Bob Merton's answer. Well, I see this as a tough engineering problem, not one of a new science. We know how to approach it in principle, but actually doing it is the challenge. Well, so today I would like to talk to you about the principles and the practicalities of designing meaningful retirement solutions. And that's a big step forward in the investment management world, which is a very exciting new development. Okay, so we're talking about mass customized retirement solutions and why they are useful. If you think about the goals that people have across their life cycles, I mean, individuals and households, you can think about financing home acquisition, you can think about financing children education, and then you can think about financing consumption in retirement, right? There may be other goals, but these are probably some of the most important goals. Actually, preparing for retirement has become the greatest challenge. And that's increasingly challenging as time goes by. What we've seen was a weakening of state pension systems, what we call Pillar 1 of retirement services, which is the fact that you get a retirement income from the state. Well, this is weakening in all states. Pillar 2 is also weakening. So Pillar 2 was pension benefits from, you know, the company that for which you work. Now the problem is those corporations are increasingly moving away from defined benefit pension plans, whereby you had safety in terms of the kind of benefits you would get. That's why we call them defined benefits, DB, pension plans. Now the world is increasingly shifting towards DC, meaning defined contribution schemes, where the risk of retirement is not on the sponsor company, but is on the investor. So in other words, the sponsor company commits to making certain level of contribution, but doesn't commit to paying off certain level of benefits. So the risk is on the individual. So now this, you know, implies that eventually individual retirement accounts will have to be, you know, Pillar 3 of retirement planning, will have to be, very useful. We've got to make the most of that because, you know, that's going to be an increasing important part of our ability to meet retirement needs. Now, just to take a look at the U.S. example, I mean, the total U.S. market is a big market. The retirement market is something like $25 trillion. So it's a huge market. But the interesting thing here is the pattern where you see a big decrease over time of the fraction of the pension plans for the largest company that offer defined benefit schemes and the increasing proportion of those plans that are actually offering defined contribution benefits. So this is a big pattern, very dramatic pattern, moving away from defined benefits toward defined contribution, meaning the risk of retirement is no longer taken by the corporations, it's all on the investors. Now, we understand what it means. It means that if you're facing a DC, defined contribution type of environment, where you don't know what you're going to get, Well, you still have the same needs, and the same needs are defined benefits. So as an individual, I need to be able to rely on a given target level of replacement income in retirement. My need hasn't changed. That's what I get that has changed, that has become very volatile and very uncertain. Now, existing retirement products don't meet the challenge. So we have, unfortunately, good reasons to believe that existing retirement products are ill-suited to meet the needs of investors preparing for retirement. So what are those products? Well, first of all, you've got insurance products. Insurance products are like annuities and also variable annuities, you know, the kind of things that would provide replacement income in retirement. Well, that sounds good, right? I mean, replacement income in retirement from retirement date until, you know, the time when you don't need consumption anymore. Let's put it this way. Well, that's exactly what you need. So annuities sounds like they do the job. Well, in theory, yes, but in practice, they don't. And, you know, the reason why they don't do the jobs are actually manifold. First of all, they are unavailable at all dates in accumulation. So you can't invest as a 30 years or 40 years investor preparing for retirement. It's very hard for you to be able to buy a deferred annuity that's like 25 years out, if you will. Then they are cost inefficient. They are extremely expensive. They are, very high capital charges that these insurance companies have to abide with. And then therefore, that makes, you know, these products extremely kind of, you know, expensive. Plus, you suffer from a lack of transparency and flexibility. In other words, it's not like you can get in and out of these products. There's no exit unless at the cost of extremely high surrender charges. And all of these combined facts explain what we call in academia the annuity puzzle. The annuity puzzle stands for the fact that annuities on paper are the meaningful asset for retirement planning. And when you give people the choice between different options, no one wants to get annuities. In the UK, well, there used to be forced annuitization before. Now there's Pension Freedom Act that allows people to actually, they don't have to go for annuitization anymore. Well, you know, the vast majority of investors have moved away from annuities for these reasons that we talked about. Okay, so what else? Well, then we get asset management products. And they are products that actually sound good also on paper. We call them target date funds. We also call them life cycle funds. And they really sound good because they have been engineered to take care of the needs of investors throughout their life cycle. And that sounds like exactly what you need. So maybe I should not allocate in the same way when I'm a young, worker and compared to when I'm close to retirement, where, you know, the deadline is approaching very fast. Well, that's what kind of target date funds are trying to accomplish, and that's what they're seeking to deliver. Well, the problem is we have many reasons to believe that these target date funds are very ill-suited. I mean, in their standard form, in their basic form, they are ill-suited for meeting the challenge for many reasons again, but, you know, first of all, and perhaps most importantly, because they have zero focus, no focus on replacement income. So these guys are products. They are not retirement solutions. So we know what we need. We need a meaningful retirement solution that would allow individual investors to secure minimum level of replacement income, let's call that an essential goal, and generate attractive probabilities to reach target levels of replacement income, which we can call an aspirational goal. And even though we're all different in the sense that we don't have the same level of contribution, we do not retire at the same date, so we're all very different, but our basic needs are actually very similar. We need replacement income, including a minimum and a target level. So because our needs are somewhat similar, it sounds possible, and it should be possible, and it actually is possible, to deliver a mass customized set of meaningful retirement solutions that actually would accomplish these goals. We know how to do this in principle. That's what Bob Merton says. And we knew that in 2003, so hopefully 15 years later, we also knew that now even better. As always, you need three components for this meaningful retirement strategy. We need hedging. And hedging comes from a smart, safe building blocks that we call a goal hedging portfolio. And a goal hedging portfolio is a portfolio that's actually replicating the payoff that you need. What is the payoff that you need? Well, you need replacement income, cost of living adjusted. Not now, but at retirement date, for so many years in retirement. Well, so what is a gold hedging portfolio? It's a forward start inflation-linked bond ladder replicating replacement income cash flows. So it's a portfolio of bonds. Let's say you're 45 years old. That's not going to pay off anything now, but in 20 years' time from now, when you start retiring, that's going to pay off a dollar plus inflation. I'm saying a dollar because I'm talking about like low unit bonds. And then you buy many of these bonds and they give you many dollars worth of replacement income plus retirement. So they feel a little bit like annuities, but they are better than annuities in the sense that they are entirely reversible because they are, you know, bond portfolios invested in extremely liquid markets like treasury bonds. So you can sell them anytime you need. Of course, there's a flip side. They don't offer you longevity risk protection. So of course, you know, it would be useful for you also to buy deferred annuities, but not early on in the accumulation phase of your life cycle, but instead on retirement date. So the gold hedging portfolio will take care of, let's say, the first 15 years or maybe 20 years in retirement of your needs for the first 20 years. And then something else, like if, you know, deferred annuity is going to take care of the late life kind of longevity risk, if you will. Now, you also need diversification through another building block, which is the risky portfolio. We call that the performance-seeking portfolio, or PSP in short. And this is a multi-asset portfolio that does as good a job as possible in terms of harvesting risk premium across and within asset classes. And why do you need that risky portfolio? And not only the safe portfolio. Well, we need the risky portfolio because we need to generate upside. Because more often than not, unfortunately, we start underfunded. We can't just buy inflation-linked bonds to secure our consumption needs. Because if we do that, we can't secure the kind of consumption needs level that is our target. So we need upside, and upside comes from the risky portfolio. And then we need insurance, the third and last form of risk management. And insurance comes under the form of a smart, well, smart doesn't mean much, but meaningful dynamic allocation to the two building blocks. And the meaningful allocation to the two building blocks is implemented in such a way that you get zero allocation to the risky component, either when you're stuck at the essential goal because risk-taking is no longer feasible, or when you've reached the essential goal because risk-taking is no longer needed or desirable. Let me give you an example. So this is the kind of payoff that a meaningful retirement solution would give you. Let's say you start with a given contribution level, and that contribution level has a purchasing power that I'm going to normalize at 100%. By purchasing power, I mean purchasing power in terms of cost of living adjusted replacement income in retirement 20 years from now. Here is what a meaningful kind of goal-based investing retirement solution would do for you. It would give you the highest possible probability to reach your targets. Let's say the target is 130. I mean, I guess here it says 30%, but you should read 130%. So that's what the target is. And the minimum is 80%, okay, of your current funding ratio, right? So you start 100%, not of your needs, 100% of your purchasing power. And you did upside. Let's say upside, you need 30% more upside. Well, here is what the strategy does for you. There's a huge probability that you get to the target, which is 130. And in the worst possible market scenarios, when the whole world conspires against you, when markets go down, the risky portfolio does poorly, of course, you're not going to get to the target, but at least you're going to secure the minimum, 80%. Well, that's pretty cool. Now, it is pretty cool, but it's actually too good to be true. That's like an optimal portfolio strategy that cannot be implemented because actually it involves unreasonably high level of leverage. You would have to trade continuously to get to that payoff. So let's take a look at an implementable payoff instead, which is something that's implemented quarterly. There's no leverage. It's very simple, quarterly rebalancing between two building blocks, the risky and the safe. Okay, what is it that we find? We find, again, a pattern. And the pattern is, it's a well-constructed payoff that actually focuses on the essential goal and the aspirational goal. So as in any good, meaningful, goal-based investing solution, most of the probability is concentrated around the investor goals, as opposed to being spread out all over the place. Well, Look at this. That's what it means being spread out all over the place. This is ugly looking payoff. That's like a bond index. That's like an equity index. That's like a balance fund that gives you 50-50. And that's like a typical target date fund. Okay, so all of these guys are potentially good products, but they are meaningless for the retirement context. Look at this target date fund. Are we securing the minimum? No, we're not. There are many scenarios in which we get less than 80%. Now, there are also many scenarios in which we get more than 130%. But remember, that wasn't part of the objective. The client, the investor has said, well, my target is 130 and my minimum is 80. So these payoffs have no shape. They are like flat. Well, that's not what we need. We need payoffs that are actually concentrated. The probability, of outcomes. Focusing these probabilities of the outcomes towards the meaningful outcomes that are the target and the minimum. Well, these goal-based investing principles are very important, and they are actually about to reshape the entire retirement space. And we are very close, and actually in the process of implementing these paradigm changes. And the industry as a whole is kind of regrouping itself and saying, okay, no more products. We should focus on meaningful solutions. Now, to facilitate the transition and to kind of foster and enhance awareness and understanding of the usefulness of liability-driven investing used in institutional money management, and explaining that they can also be extremely useful when used in individual money management, and particularly apply to the retirement problem. Well, to enhance this awareness, we are launching a new initiative with our partner at Princeton University. And this new initiative is called the EDEC Princeton Goal-Based Investing Indices. So what they are? Well, they are benchmarks for innovative, mass-customized, retirement, meaningful retirement investment solutions. And they have been engineered and designed so as to take into account both changes in market conditions, but also, investors' goals. And that's what makes them meaningful investment solutions. Now, this is all about mass customization of meaningful investment solutions. Well, next time, for the next video, we're going to be talking about mass distribution, which is the next challenge, right? We've been talking about mass production, mass customization, but now these meaningful, retirement solutions, mass customized, they have to be provided to the public at large. So that's a mass production challenge. So next time, we're going to talk about how the digital disruption can actually be a very strong force accelerating the move that will allow us to actually not only mass produce and mass customize, but also mass distribute meaningful investment solutions.